about da'wah, to refute her doubts.
I told you.
You told me to give her da'wah.
You refute her doubts about the existence of Allah. Because she doesn't believe in the existence of Allah.
Yeah, but if she
believes. I wouldn't tell you to give her da'wah, because then you would give her misguidance. Maybe you'd
no, you told me, you listen to me. You said, give her da'wah.
Misguidance and kufr.
Yeah. So if I'm a kafir, I'm going to misguide her more.
No,
he told me, he said, give her da'wah, but don't talk about Sheikh Rabia. He's as if when I give da'wah to people, talk about Sheikh Rabia. That's what he said to me.
I said, don't talk about jihad.
You said, jihad.
I said, don't talk about jihad.
Why? But we don't talk about jihad anyway. We'll give da'wah.
She's going to ask you about jihad, and you'll ask. She'll probably ask.
What would you believe about jihad?
Huh?
What do you believe about jihad? Why? You said you believe in jihad. There's jihad talib or jihad difa.
Alhamdulillah. I'm almost saying it.
So how I don't believe in jihad? I believe in jihad, I believe there's jihad talib and jihad difa. You see? Is that correct?
Explain both.
Jihad talib when you go out, spread Islam, it's called jihad talib. And jihad difa is the defensive one. And that jihad talib, as Ibn Taymiyyah mentioned in his Rad al Nasara, he said that jihad talib, which is laid out of necessity, is darura. The asl is not jihad. It's not jihad talib, the asl. The asl is to give da'wah. But when the people start fighting against Islam and the Muslim, Allah legislated jihad to fight back against the what they call it, to remove the tyrants. Yeah, but not to kill innocent people. You come to Britain, you have a passport, British passport, or you have a visa, and you say, I'm doing jihad here. That's not jihad, that's not jihad. Allah said, Ufu bil uqud. You know? Ufu bil uqud. What you say is allowed to do with suicide bombing here? So I'm lying, this is what I'm saying is true. So is a suicide bombing okay to kill people? So I said, it's not okay, so I'm lying.
It's as if you're trying to push me in prison. You're filming me with like...
No, but you said I'm lying, and you agree what I said.
You make a claim.
Yeah, but kids, we're lying.
No, I'm okay. Listen, let me tell you something.
You made a claim. I said suicide bombings is haram in Islam. Sheikh Bin Baz, he said, he said, it's allowed in a battlefield, in a war. If a leader says you're going to kill more enemies in a war, not killing innocent people, in a battlefield. He said, you go kill the enemies, you're allowed to do that. Some scholars don't agree with it. Some scholars don't agree with it. Understand? So, my point here is, as for going to come into Britain, or going to France, and going to Belgium, you get a contract, and all of that, and you go, even if you have no contract, you come in as illegal immigrants, and you go kill innocent people, claiming that it's Islam and jihad, that is a jihad of a Satan. Not jihad of Islam. You understand?
And you need permission
yeah.
from the leader first.
Yes, eh?
You need the permission.
Yeah, you need the permission from the leader, you know? And you know, jihad is not for a group of mental people. No, jihad, it goes back to the hakim, to the leader. No one should be take that right from the leader himself. You know, no, a headless chicken running around and then fight, he said jihad. So jihad is an honor, act of worship, but people misuse it. Just as people misuse the word of freedom. You understand? So the alhamdulillah. Wallah, he told me that guy was speaking. He told me give da'wah to my sister. He said, but don't tell about Sheikh Rabia. As if when I give da'wah to people, you watch my videos. I never give da'wah and I said, believe in Sheikh Rabia. You know, if someone doesn't believe Sheikh Rabia exists, is he Salafi?
As if he's a Rasul.
Wallah al-Adim. As if he doesn't agree with Sheikh Rabia, said something. Like, Sheikh Rabia believes you should not use videos. Wallah, people lie and guess us about the issue of Sheikh Rabia. This is a lie. What we call to La ilaha illa Muhammad Rasulullah. You know, subhanAllah. Akhi. May Allah guide this person, man. I think he's not.
He, like the child. Yeah, I don't think.
May Allah guide him, man. Allah salama wa al-afiya. Yeah, alhamdulillah, anyway, we're speaking to him. Who is that guy we have to speak to? The Nigerian. I have to take him aside without that Indian guy. Hashim, okay. Subhanallah, look at that, yeah? You believe Jesus is God, but Jesus was asking help from the Father. But God is not in need of help. Like, how that? Subhanallah. God is asking someone to help him. Because he's scared to die. Come on, man. Doesn't make any sense. Alhamdulillah for Islam. Wallahi, eh? Ta'ala Allah uluwan kabiran amma yaqulu al-zalimun. Subhanallah. Wa ma qadaru Allah haqqa qadrih. Wal ardu jami'an qabdatuhu yawm al-qiyamah. Wal samawatu matwiyatun biyaminih. Subhanahu wa ta'ala amma yushrikun. They have to estimate Allah the way should be estimated. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, even just saying God become a baby, you are mentally gone. Subhanallah, you don't need detailed refutation. That's what Allah said about Maryam and Isa. Kana ya'kulani ta'am. Yeah, they used to eat foods. And that's what Ma'idah. They used to eat food. Subhanallah. What Allah is mentioning that to show us that subhanallah, that is not God. Why Ibn Kathir mentioned? Because Allah is self-sufficient. If they are in need of food, they cannot be the same God who is self-sufficient all the time. Simple way. The guy said he was a Muslim. He was not a Muslim, a liar, man. People lie. Because what they've seen, many Christians, atheists accepted Islam. Some Christians who live, because you know there's some Nigerians I met personally, they can't recite Surah Al-Fatiha and he's a Christian.
Yes.
Why? Because they're mixed. They have Muslim family and all of that, yeah, you know?
Like some Egyptian.
Egyptian as well. They can recite Surah Al-Fatiha as well. Yeah. Yeah. Because when I said to him, I repeated twice, more than twice. I said, how many rak'ah Surah Al-Fatiha? He said, I don't know. He doesn't know how many rak'ah. He said, no, I didn't know. He's a kadab, man. Alhamdulillah for Islam. Let's go inside, inshallah.
Like one Egyptian was here in the corner.
Yeah.
And he was saying that he was ex-Muslim. Then I told him, tell me tahiyya.
Tahiyya to Allah.
He said for 20 years, he don't know tahiyya.
Yeah, like guys, 35 years Muslim, praying, doesn't know tahiyya to Allah. Come on, pray, tahiyya to Allah, you do every time you pray.
Yeah.
You know, 35 years. You know, that's why, you know, there's a Christian guy, what's his name, I forgot, he's Kurdish, yeah? I said to him, before he became a Christian, you were Muslim, Korea said yes. I said, were you educated Muslim or layman? He said, no, I was educated Muslim. I said, what is Tawheed? He said, what the heck is that? He said, what? I said, okay, no problem. I said, same thing. I said, Tahiyyatu lillah, in the prayer. He said, what's this? You're a liar, man. Become business here. You know, some Kurdish, they're not even Muslims. You know, they're Christians. They want British passport. So they come here and said, I'm a Muslim. I cannot go back to Iraq. They will kill me. You understand? Liars, man. You know, there's one guy, yeah, I think in Sweden or one of the European countries, he burned the Quran to show them he cannot go back to Egypt. You know, but they still send him back. Alhamdulillah, good for him. Because why? Swedish speaking, you know what? This guy, he sold his country because of passport, he will sell us too. Send him back.
Yeah, it's true.
Wallahi, man, you have to sell yourself like that, begging for to live here. Na'udhu billah min dalik, man. May Allah protect us, man. Wallahi, akhi, may Allah save us from this humiliation, bro. And they know you. They can think, you know, this guy for passport, he's not gonna go with him inside the grave. He's doing all of that. So if the enemy attack us, he will be against us, this guy.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying, akhi?
Yeah.
You know, that's why non-Muslims, if they see you proud of deen, proud of Islam, proud of who you are, they'll respect you more. Wallahi, even if they don't agree with you, but they respect you more. Because they say, man, he's a man, he is proud of his deen. He holds his, to his principles, yes.
No, but if they think properly, they are too many. They didn't say we are become Christian or Jew, whatever.
Yeah.
They get visa, they get
through
the will of Allah.
Yes, they send him back. This Egyptian guy, they sent him back. Allah, they didn't care. If you're a Christian, maybe you're lying.
One Egyptian, Allah, he told me that he told for his friend, happened to him. He said that he told him that he is gay. They bring for him a man.
Yeah, نعوذ بالله من ذلك.
They bring for him a man.
نعوذ بالله من ذلك.
If
it's a real guy, yeah. نعوذ بالله من ذلك. May Allah protect us. Let me give you this fa'idah, who I've read, share this benefit with you. Ibn Qayyim, may Allah have mercy upon him, said in Kitab al-Fawa'id. You know, sometimes you hear the scholar say, leaving off the prayer is worse than drinking alcohol and fornication. Correct? You've heard that before? You think, how? Leaving, abandon the prayer? Ibn Qayyim, may Allah have mercy upon him, quoting Abdullah ibn Salih Tustari in his Kitab al-Fawa'id. He said, leaving the commandments is worse than Bob. Leaving the commandments, Bob, we finished you many times. Leaving the commandments is worse than falling into prohibitions. Leaving the awamir is worse than falling into the nawahi. The example of that he gave, Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, he fell into the nahi, a year prohibition. He made tawbah and he turned back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why he fell into the nahi? Because out of desires, hawa. Why Iblis didn't want to prostrate? Out of takabbur.
Yeah.
So the one doesn't know pray, Ibn Taymiyyah mentioned his mutakabbir. That's why the mutakabbir is worse than someone who's following his desires. Because the one is following his desires, he knows that, you know, I got tired, I'm wrong. But that, the one who you pray, living off the prayer, mutakabbir. But a person might say, I know many Muslims, they're not mutakabbir, they're very good. How many non-Muslims, they're very good interacting with the people, but doesn't believe in Allah, because deep down they're mutakabbir. So my brothers out there, do you want to be called mutakabbir? Be mutakabbir too, to your Lord? So pray. You know, and also let me clarify something. It doesn't mean because you pray and you do haram, you're a hypocrite. That is a wrong definition of hypocrite. Hypocrite, someone who doesn't believe in Allah from within, he's a kafir, wal'iyadu billah. From outside, he pretends to be Muslim. As for someone who prays, try his best to stay from haram, but now and then, or he's been tried with smoking drugs or doing other harams, doesn't mean he's a hypocrite. He's a Muslim sinner. But which one is better? Someone who is doing salat and falling to haram, much better than someone who does not pray. Because the ones that pray is mutakabbir, arrogant. In front of who? From his creator. Wal'iyadu billah. So these benefits, subhanAllah, put everything into perspective.
Plus the person who prays, all the time he remembers what he's doing. And he will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Wallahi, that's what happened to me when I started practicing. Yeah. Certain things was hard for me. And I remember I had friends of mine, they said, Shamsi, you're munafiq. Why? Because you pray and you do this. I said, yeah, it's true. So I left the prayer. But my brother said, no, you're not munafiq. You mashallah, good. You try your best, you know? So it's better off to keep struggling. So I was doing it. Then I thought, you know what? It's a time to leave. I left, alhamdulillah. See? Alhamdulillah. So there's some Muslim friends. Wallahi, they are shayateen ins. Wallahi, choose your friends. Instead of supporting you, they want you to be like them. Don't pray at all. And remember, the ones that pray is a kafir. What is kafir? Someone with a kafir in front of his Lord. You know? So remember that prayer and how to preserve the prayer. Make sure you pray on time. Especially if you just start praying again. Don't delay it. Don't pray five prayers at Isha time. No. Inna salata kanat al mu'minina kitaban mawquta. On a fixed time. Allah said, wa'aqimu salat. You know Allah said, wa'aqimu salat. Establish the prayer. The prayer is very important, ya akhwa. You know, one of the ulama of Malikiyya, in his kitab fiqh, he said, yeah, if someone does not pray, he said, tandiriyan, laysa tatbiqiyan. What does that mean? In theory, because it is not, and it has not happened in history, Muslim does not pray. He's a Moroccan scholar, Maliki. During his lifetime, he said, you cannot picture a Muslim does not pray. Now, subhanallah. You know, subhanallah. So we have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, we're not perfect. All of us, we have our own struggles. All of us.
What about the people who they found like excuses? Like, for example, like you have a job and they can't pray in job.
So he's like Haman. Ibn Qayyim mentioned, if you don't pray and you turn away from the prayer, like Haman. What is it?
He just called your name. I don't know who that is.
He's like Haman. You know Haman? Haman, he left worshipping Allah because of what? Because of wealth. Qarun. Haman because of his status. Qarun because of his wealth. So Ibn Qayyim said, anyone that abandoned the prayer because of his job and his wealth, he will be with Qarun in Jahannam. Wal'iyadu billah. You know? And yes.
One who delays a prayer within its time.
Second?
Delays a prayer within its time, within the prayer time, but he delays it.
That's haram, it's a major sin.
Within the time, so for example...
You're not delaying the prayer.
That's not delaying the prayer. No, so you pray within the time of Asr, but like towards maybe...
It's okay, that's the time. But not when the sun is about to...
Not at sunset. Not
yeah, no, no, maybe like a sa'ah before that. Sa'ah, by the way, when you go back to the Prophet Muhammad mentioned sa'ah, doesn't mean 1 hour. It's a period of time.
Yeah.
Doesn't mean from 1 to 12, 1 to 2. You understand? So, yes. So that's why Jibril alayhi salam, when he came to teach Nabi alayhi salam how to pray, he came... In the beginning of the time, in the middle of the time, and before the finish. Like, you know, door prayer start from when the door comes in, and just a few minutes before Asr. Except Maghrib has to be like an hour before. Yeah.
Hour before Isha?
Before Maghrib. Except for Asr.
Oh, okay.
Asr, you cannot pray Asr until Maghrib has about 2 minutes left, no. Because why? That's when the sun is setting. You know, it's Muharram. And how many times, see, brothers, don't pray Asr on time? Ask very important, you know, ask especially because when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَحَافِدُوا عَلَى الصَّلَوَاتِ وَالصَّلَاةِ الْوُسْطَى وَقُومُوا لِلَّهِ قَانِتِينَ. Preserve the prayer and the middle prayer. Some scholars differ, what is the middle prayer? Some said Fajr, some said Asr. But ask very important. You know, ask prayer is very important. So we have to, all of us.
The
barakallahu fik, na'am. Because you know, ask, they say that's the moment when everyone's busy with business. Everyone, you see? So that's when you see who you love more. Your work, your job, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Excuse, it's very easy, you know. I work as well, and to pray at work is...
Alhamdulillah, be proud, tell them, listen. Be proud, I'm a Muslim. For Jumu'ah, I have to go pray Jumu'ah. And also, during the day, I need some time to pray. Are you going to accept me? No. Alhamdulillah, Allah is the Razzaq, not you. But what happened? We start, because of our deficiency in our iman, we start believing in our bosses more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We think the boss, the risk is in the hand of the boss.
Yeah.
The risk is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
They think he pays your wage. But
yeah.
Allah.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wallahi. Akhi, literally sometimes you can be at home and people told me you can be at this brother told me a story, yeah. He said, akhi, once I was at home, someone called me. I said, yeah, assalamu alaikum. He said, 10 years, you forgot, we did business. He did business with him, yeah? And he said, I was in need of money that time. He said, I forgot about this guy. He said, look, I regret for what I did. I've been looking for you for a long time. We did the business. I bought trainers from you. It cost nearly £3,000. Now I may tell Bahi, I'm calling you to bring you £3,000. This guy, he was at home. He didn't do nothing. To show you Allah the Razzaq. Allah is the Razzaq. He said, brother, I was thinking, how I'm going to get money? How? Allah bring you money. Allah wants. Doesn't mean you stay home, brothers, yeah? Don't stay home, wait for someone to call you. Okay? We take the asbab. But Allah, sometimes what Allah show us, Allah shows you, Allah is able to break the laws. Because He created the laws of this universe, He can break it too. You see, subhanAllah. Literally at home, He said, Akhi, I was in need of money. Allahu Akbar. And how many hardships we're going through? And from the worldly view, everything's good. And guess what you want? But you still get it. That shows you purely this from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No human being was involved in it. Wallahi, akhi, certain things happened to me in my life. I knew that this too much is from Allah, clearly. Wallahi. So when you push us on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know Allah is the Razzaq. He's in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We see wallahi, Allah provides for you. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left Mecca, akhi. You know, Sahaba. Left everything, akhi. Left their wealth, everything. Allah provides for them. But us, you know, my iman, Allah al-musta'ana, what iman. No, no, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, you know, well, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, he said, what you left for your children, he said, I left Allah and His Messenger. You know, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, let's talk about the virtue of Sahaba, for the Shia to understand. These people will lie, the Islam in Nasr will kufri kasaru, anyway. For Abu Bakr al-Siddiq gave all his wealth away. And he said to, and Nabi Asasim said to him, yeah, Abu Bakr, what have you left for your family? He said, I left Allah and His Messenger. The ulama said, can anyone other than Abu Bakr do it? He said, no one can do it. Other than Abu Bakr. From the Sahaba or other than Sahaba. Because Abu Bakr's iman is powerful. Because if I do it, me personally, two weeks later, I think, how come no money? You know, I start doubting, al-Iyadu Billah. But Abu Bakr's iman, nothing can touch it. Subhanallah. Why is it called Abu Bakr al-Siddiq? Abu Bakr al-Siddiq is a smart person. He's a wise person. Look to that sound reasoning. You know, sound aql of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. When the Kufar of Quraysh came to him, he said, oh Abu Bakr, your prophet is claiming that he traveled from Mecca to Al-Aqsa to Sama' Sabi'ah in one night. But Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, watch. First, look to his iman. He said, he doesn't know because maybe they're lying. They misquoted Prophet. He said, if he said it, I believe in it. The iman to Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, yeah? And but look now, using sound reasoning, yeah? He said, I believe in something greater than that. What is it? I believe he received the revelation from the sky in a second. So which one is more greater for him to travel from here to Jerusalem in one night or to receive a revelation? That's how to use sound reasoning. Huh? Look, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radhiyallahu anhu, arda, Sahaba. They never went to Oxford University. They never went to Cambridge University. I'm not saying don't go. We study, alhamdulillah, no doubt. But they never went to none of these universities. They became leaders of nations. Subhanallah. Us, our time, subhanAllah, may Allah forgive us all. And may Allah guide us. But we have to learn our deen, brothers. And don't come here just to waste your time. Wallahi, it's better off stay, learn your deen, get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and seek forgiveness. All of us, we have our own struggles. We commit mistakes, you know. But istighfar. Regardless how much sins you commit, Allah's mercy is greater than it. And as I've been mentioned, the author, whoever seek forgiveness after commit sin, then laysa bi musir, aw kama qala alayhi salatu wasalam. He's not a person who insists upon the sin. You know? So do our best, may Allah bless you all, wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in, wa sallam, salman kathira.